a strange hair today. It's weird. I think it's just strange. Oh, anyway, you're not here for that. Let me talk about fragrance. Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers, this is Clémence, I talk about fragrance, et welcome back! Cringy. Okay, so today I'm talking to you about 5 fragrances that blew my mind this 2021, and I really wanted to talk to you about them. They're also really sensual, rich, and something that definitely will make you stand out in front of your loved ones. Definitely. Also very unique, I wanted to find something unique. In 2021, I want to find new houses, find something that is different. So let me talk to you through it. Number one, a house that I discovered recently, and it's called Matière Première. So if you don't know Matière Première, it's a French perfuming house, super, extremely qualitative. Let me tell you something, I've tried the range, and I was just mind blown through all the range. I actually struggled to pick just one, so I think I'm just gonna do a video about Matière Première in depth, because it was an absolute love, and I think I'm just gonna spend all my money on them. The quality is there, the richness, the blend of ingredients. You know, it reminds me of a florist, but more richer, more opulent. And I just really adore the vibe of this. There's one fragrance that I chose that was so pretty that you would die for. So those fragrances are quite unisex. I will tell you if it leans more masculine or feminine, but for this one, it's completely unisex. Doesn't have gender to me. This is called Encens Suave. So this is an incense fragrance, very dark, rich and addictive, and it's meant to be super sensual. This is the level of Grand Soir from MFK, to tell you how much I love it. Being round and soft, so it smells, there's a coffee note that is really not a crusty, roasty coffee. It's more like a soft Nespresso martini vibe. I don't really smell it that much in there. What I can smell is a lot of benzoin, waxy vanilla, so nearly like amber-like fragrance. So if you enjoy oriental and ambery fragrance, you're gonna love this. So it's more benzoin. So benzoin smells a bit more waxy and smoky, and it's got like a religious kind of tone. If you ever smell Fucking Fabulous Tom Ford, you're gonna really enjoy that. I think it's a bit more classier than Fucking Fabulous to me, but you really have this incense vibe that is really there without feeling as much churchy as Fucking Fabulous does. A slight leather tone at the end, but if you don't like leather, don't be scared. It's really like a backbone again. All the ingredients are super dosed lightly, so there's not any of them that is going on top of those ones. Like when I smell that, I just smell a perfectly blended fragrance, and this incense is really encapsulating all the blend. So really rich, you can smell a vanilla-like tone. So gourmand, after all, you want to eat it, it's delicious. That's why I'm telling you that it's gonna make everyone fall in love. Like, it's something I would wear on a date in an evening to impress someone, because it's so sensual and addictive. Like, if you want to make the good impression, definitely that, and you stand out as well, because it's not something I smell everywhere. Definitely not. Just perfection to me. It's perfection. Second fragrance is a recent addition. It's unisex to me, but it's leaning more masculine. Really a gentleman vibe, and it's Straight to Heaven by Killian. So first of all, I received it in that box. Look at that, with the cobra over there. It's absolutely stunning, so luxurious. I had that in my handbag when I went to France all the time. And I remember I sprayed a little bit, like I was with my friend, and I sprayed a little bit, and everyone was like, what was this. The bottle is really luxurious, you know what you're paying for. It's got the signature of Baikilian, which is a very boozy fragrance, a lot of rum. If you don't like woody fragrance, you're not gonna like that. It's very woody. Of nutmeg as well, so slightly greener and nutty, vanilla, amber background, but really what stands out is the wood. So addictive to me, sexy, it's boozy, it's just, you know, when I smelled that for the first time, I was like, I see a man, right? I see a man in a lounge bar with a turtleneck, black turtleneck, a beard, but well-groomed, kind of tuxedo jacket, you know, but like maybe a bit tweedish or something like that. This guy is sipping his whiskey in the bar and suddenly he turns and he sees me and we're like, oh, hello. That really makes me think of gentleman scent from before, like a vintage scent, but with a very modern approach. If it was too overwhelming, like too intoxicating, I think the woods would be really too much. But the fact that it's really calming down on the skin and gets something like very soft at the end and nearly powdery, gets really this fragrance so classy. And for me, it gives something more than classy. It's a bit provocative as well. It's not something that you're gonna wear at office, you know. Personally, I really adore it on me, but that's my taste. I like woody fragrance, so voilà. Number three, so we're gonna go to Spain for this one. Encuentro en el Puerto, Reina Victoria. And it's by Loewe. Loewe? Loewe, I'm not too sure. I'm sorry, like, I did do German and English at school, so my Spanish is not there, except gracias, mi casa es tu casa. Let's just stop there. This fragrance is super elegant again, and I find it very easy to wear. This is my scent of the day, by the way. This is an opening that is slightly citrusy with bergamot, but very discreet. Hein? It's just there to give some fizziness, I think, to the fragrance. And then cypress to give like something a bit more greener. You've got a heart that is slightly more flowery. Dry down is very oriental and waxy again. You can smell amber, really, like that richness of oriental, but it's really waxy, nearly balsamic. Spicy, it's warm, it's comforting, really easy to wear. And is it raining or is it snow? What? It's snow! Okay, anyway, leathery as well. It's got a touch of leather, but overall, I find it very classy, warm, comforting. You can really spray it on the daytime. Usually the thing with oriental is only like wintry and something that you're gonna wear in the evening. This is really nice to wear in the daytime. It's not too overwhelming. I'm gonna do a full review on Loewe fragrance because I've got a full set of it. You can smell a bit of the cardamom as well. So if you want something feminine, classy, sensual, easy to wear as well, but a good step into something niche. Well, when I say niche, it's more like the creative side of it. You're gonna really enjoy that. Really a big crush. Next on that. Next one is from Centauri Perfume. So this is coming from one of our fragrance reviewers in the community, which is Peter from Fragrance View. What I enjoy with that first is it really pushing the creativity. And you know, like I think he knows fragrance, he knows how it is. So I think he's really trying to work with something creative. I like the full aura of Centauri fragrance. It's snowing. I'm just sorry. So I've tried all the range. I was really impressed by the creativity of the range, especially from I really enjoyed Dendera as a oud fragrance, like very spicy, ambery, really loved it. I'm fascinated by the snow. Enjoyed Dendera, but I was really pleasantly surprised. I wanted to show you something I'm not used to. And for me, there was a standout really in the range, which was Proxima. Proximas is a very fruity bomb to me in the opening. If you don't like, you know, the strawberry, wild berries, fruit, you're probably not gonna like that. But like for me, it was an explosion of this fruit, and usually I don't really like it, but I really liked this one. Nearly like cassis-like feeling. So Proximus, first of all, this bottle. Can we talk about this bottle? I mean, it's absolutely stunning. I just love it. Love the vibe. Very fizzy fragrance. So it's nearly like cocktail-like because you've got the aldehydes that are there like to give some fizziness to the fragrance. It really uplift on top of the skin. So it's really, really beautiful to wear. And it's got a tropical approach. So really, when you smell it, for me, it smells like juicy tropical. Nearly makes me think of Pomelo Paradis from Atelier Cologne, but much more richer, much more creative. What I like is that it's alluring and it's also something very different. I didn't comment on it saying that it's generic. Excuse me, I never smelled it like in generic fragrance, like no. It's very invigorating, richer, and it's kind of the smell that I would love. Fruity smell is not easy. Fruit like this, like tropical, are not easy to wear during winter. Well, I think that is really comforting, and I think I'm gonna wear it during all summer as well. But I think for winter, it gives like really a cocooning and cozy effect as well. So I'm really, really pleasantly surprised with that. And with the time, I just got it there. With the time, it dried down to something more clean and a bit more powdery. So I find it really interesting. And even like the dry down is a bit more warmer as well. So after the punch of fruit, you get this warmness, dry down, slightly more powdery. Absolutely stunning. Really love this creation. And I'm really happy to talk about it, especially when it's coming from one of my fellow friends, fragrance reviewer, because Peter is a really nice guy and he's very knowledgeable, so highly recommended to have a try in this
and
fragrance.
Number 5 is by Agathe Eau Parfum. Agathe Eau Parfum that I discovered in Scent Explore.
Luxurious house, there's one fragrance that really blew my mind, and it's called Castamenti. You know, I was thinking, I smelled that before, but where? You know Saint Salim? You know, I always talk about Saint Salim for their oil and their musk. If you ever try Moroccan musk or things from Saint Salim like this kind of like oriental fragrance, this smells like this to me. The oud, it's absolutely gorgeous. Like what I really like is there's a richness, bitterness, a sugariness with the saffron that gives a really luxurious approach to this fragrance. And you've got a rose jasmine tone. So, but don't be scared because I think it's really unisex. Like, you know, like rosy fragrance on men really blossoms, but this, because it's got like so much musk and oud and incense and labdanum, so labdanum smell leathery, it goes like more like really unisex. So don't be scared of that. I think it's gonna be like something like for the evening again, but I would really be happy to wear it during winter, during daytime, like really something that stands out. It's got, compared to the other one, something more again creamy, cocooning, soft and round, and the flowery tone gives like something again more softer to it. At the beginning you can smell a slightly green vibe, leaves like, which is the laurels, a slightly incense vibe, and you know how much I like incense. So I think this is gonna be one of my easy to reach oriental to me, but easy but super luxurious and also super creative and qualitative. Really, you can smell quality in there, and it's super long lasting. I've tried it on my skin and it was really projecting, and I could keep it on my skin so long. So if you're looking for creaminess, sensuality, sexiness, but with a very oriental try, and you like oud but you don't really like animalic oud, you're gonna love this. This is stunning. The rose is quite blossoming in there, so creamy, rosy like. I think I'm gonna do a review on Agathe Eau Parfum as well because I've got the full set at some points. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please tell me what blew your mind. What is the fragrance that you're wearing at the moment that you absolutely love? I'm always happy to see you and to talk to you. I wish you a good Sunday. And I will see you very, very soon. And thank you for everyone that goes to my uTip in the description box, as usual. It's really, really nice to tip me. It really encouraged me. So thank you. I really appreciate it. And I will see you very, very soon. Bye now. Oh, I forgot to say, you can subscribe and you can like and you can share and yeah. And you can even capture a video and put it on your Instagram in the stories and tag me. That's really nice. I love when people do that. It's really nice. Very, very nice. Bye now. Have a lovely evening.